not the financial statements, especially the income statement. It is for the statement of comprehensive income. Okay, so for the statement of comprehensive income, we start with sales. If it is a manufacturing firm or a merchandising company, so we start with sales, and then we followed by what? Ano susunod dito? Kung natatandaan ninyo. Ha? Ano susunod sa sales? Natatandaan nyo pa? Sabi nyo, natatandaan nyo sa Finman. Di ba? So, ano yung sales natin? Followed by sales. Ah, Eunice, ikaw, Eunice, medyo fresh pa, di ba? Fresh graduate ka pa, Eunice. Ano?
Same po,
Ha? Kasi
same po
para,
kami.
ano susunod sa sales?
So sorry, I think I can recall it pa po.
Ano?
I don't think I can recall it pa po.
Ah, hindi ma-recall. What about you, Red? Si Red, baka nagre-research na. Red? But anyway, after sales, you have the less.
I'm not really quite sure, sir. Pero,
Hindi
pa,
na.
sir.
Ito na, nilagay ko na. Okay lang, no? So, we have the cost of sales, no? So, after the cost of sales, we have the gross profit. Then followed by operating expenses. So, under the operating expenses, you have the selling, and you have the administrative. And then after that, you will have the EBIT. Ito na yung EBIT bale. Earnings before interest and taxes. And then after that, you less the interest expense. So you have the earnings dot after that, earnings before taxes, then less taxes, and then you have the net income, no? So, yung ganyan yung statement of comprehensive income natin. So, ito ang hinahanap natin ngayon pagdating doon sa free cash flow. Now, why free cash flow? Kasi actually, itong interest expense, ba't hindi sinama? Tsaka itong taxes, hindi rin sinama. Actually, sinama siya, no? But this one is not, this one is the one excluded. Kasi it is used for financing the operating activities. So, the reason why we are excluding the interest expense in the computation. Kaya kung makikita nyo rito ngayon, you have the EBIT only. But we deduct the taxes. Na yung tier kasi dito is tax, but one is constant. But the tier right there is the tax rate. No? Hindi timbang yan, ha? Hindi timbang. Kasi yung pangalan ko, Ferdinand Timbang. Ha? So, hindi ko pangalan niya nandyan. Ha? So, yung the T is the tax rate. Okay? So, actually, yung formula pa nga na to, eh, ganito eh. Baka magkalituan, no? Mayroon pang parenthesis actually dyan. Pagod mo. No? So, we are not including the interest expense in the formula simply because it is already part of financing. No? Financing na yan. So, hindi natin sinasama yan dito sa formula na yan. No? Kaya meron lang tayong EBIT minus 1 minus T. No? Then, the DA here is actually the depreciation and amortization. Now, why are we adding back the depreciation and amortization? Kaya lumalabas ulit, itong depreciation and amortization is added simply because when you do the complication, no, for the selling, okay, administrative, no, for the selling and administrative, the depreciation expense, the entry is depreciation expense all over accumulated. So, wala ka makikitang cash dyan, di ba? Tama ba? May nakikita ba kayong cash sa journal entry na depreciation expense? Credit no. Depreciation? Wala. But this depreciation expense, they are deducted, no? Either in the selling or administrative or both. No? Kasi for the selling office, for example, or sales department, they also have machine, no? They have equipment, they have furniture. So the same thing with the administrative, which is being depreciated. But somehow, this depreciation expense, they are deducted from the gross profit. But actually, there is no cash movement. Huh? What we are analyzing is the cash flow, in particular, the free cash flow. Because in the financial statements, no, one of the statements is actually the statement of cash flow. But the function of the statement of cash flow is different from the free cash flow. Because in the statement of our cash flow, we're looking at the increase or decrease of cash from one period to another period and what causes that increase or decrease in cash. But the free cash flow, the main function is that this is the cash that is already available for dividend payments or payment of obligations or additional investment without affecting, no, the operating activities of the company. So the reason why a positive free cash flow is very important to the company. Now it is very important. And even when you buy stocks, no? Nag stock market na ba kayo, Red? Tsaka Eunice? Nag stock market na ba kayo? Nag-invest na ba kayo? Wala, walang nag-invest in, no? Saan mo nilalagay yung may pera ka ba natitira, Eunice? Ngayon nagtatrabaho ko na Eunice, eh, di ba?
Yes, po.
Saan mga nilalagay yung pera mo pagka may excess?
Sa bank lang po ngayon.
Banko. Sa savings account lang o time deposit?
Actually, service to ko nga po pag time deposit. Pero hindi ko pa po siya naasikaso.
Oh,
pero sir, saan po yung magandang banko mag time deposit?
Ito mo sa banko, pwede, no?
Ako.
Kahit sa banko, actually, pwede. Pwede siya.
Hanapin
pero,
ko lang
kayo
mataas yung interest.
Kaya lang kasi ako, I'm not suggesting actually yung mga time deposit or savings account. No? I would rather go for the treasury bill.
Okay. Either po. Though sir, hindi nila i-request ko na lang po siya.
Okay, I'm on mutual funds or UITF, no, commercial papers. If you have at least mga 100,000 sa commercial papers, they earn better, no, than the time deposit. Because the commercial papers, it's earning around 5% or more. Or better yet, if you want to really save, you can invest in Pag-ibig, no? Pag-ibig na MP2. Ha? Ganon.
So, ano po yun, sir?
Pag-ibig, yung sa Pag-ibig na ano, na government institution, yung MP2 kung tawagin nila. Because although that one is withdrawable in 5 years, but the interest per year is around 5.25 to 6.25%. Just imagine interest na yun. It's a time deposit, nasa 0.75 lang yata yun, o 1% per annum, no? So, what about you, Ren? Pagka may excess money ka ba, saan mo nilalagay?
Though, sir, may insurance po ako ngayon.
Ah, okay lang yung insurance, no?
Oo.
Okay lang yun. Kasi yan naman ang basic ng investing, no? Insurance.
Oo.
Okay lang yun. So, what about you, Ren? So, where do you place your extra cash?
Same with Ate Eunice. Savings lang po for
now. Savings po rin. Ah, lako, ang dahil. Kaya nga, alam nyo, nung gumawa ako ng dissertation paper ko, no, when I did that, no, before becoming a doctor, ang aking ano, ang dissertation paper ko is more on investing practices of the Filipino, no, in the NCR. Hindi ko makover yung buong Pilipinas eh. Kaya NCR lang ang ginawa ko. And I found out that even professionals, no, they do not know how to place in stock market, no, in bonds, in commercial papers, treasury bill. No, the normal investment venue is actually time deposit or savings account. But you're not helping the economy to grow in that case. Pwede rin makatulong kasi sa banko naman pinasok, but it's very minimal. No, because it's not that very active. Tapos ano pa ba? Yun, 10% lang ng Pilipino. But in Singapore, siguro mga 60% know how to invest. No? Kaya investing is actually very important. Because this money, no, helps us to what? Oh, this money actually works for us, not us working for the money. Pero ako kasi sa toko lang, more on stocks ako. More on stocks, UITF, and mutual funds. No? But siguro mga 80% of my savings is actually in the stock market. And would you believe na, hindi ko sasabihin yung exact amount, ano? But would you believe that what I'm earning in the stock market is more than what I'm earning in BM College? Now, by simply placing my money in the stock market.
My sir, naka-long-term po kayo sa stocks ngayon?
Hindi. May times na long-term. May times na, kasi hindi naman ako perfect pa rin. Nagkakamali pa rin ako sa stock market, no? But one big lesson when it comes to investing actually on my part is that I choose only yung mga big companies. I always look first now at the financial statements. Unlike before, I was looking at the trend or what yung na-hype sa stock market. But actually, it's a dangerous game if you just follow the trend. So I would rather look for the fundamentals of the company. So yung sinasabi ko naman na earnings na yun, this is realized gain, ha? Hindi unrealized. Kasi I would still sell as say that I have an unrealized loss of malaki pa rin yung unrealized loss ko. But every time the price of the stock went up, no, nabibenta ko sila and then eventually I reinvest them in the stock market again. Kaya minsan nagne-negative talaga palagi. But for those I sold and for the dividends I received, I'm earning more than what I'm earning in Miriam College. Mas malaki ang kinikita ko kaysa sa Miriam. No? Ang laki ng difference. So kung kumikita ko, for example, sa Miriam College ng 100,000 in a year, ang kinikita ko sa stock market is 150,000. Kaya lang, syempre, iba pa rin yung may fixed income ka. No? So secondary income ko na lang yung stock market. And another passive income of mine is my books. No? Kasi I already wrote 7 books. Pero syempre importante pa rin yung may fixed income ka. And siguro doon ko sasabihin yung papasok yung free cash flow. Kasi I'm using that free cash flow to invest. No? So the same thing with companies. It is important for them to have free cash flow. Kasi otherwise, they will be tied. No? They will be tied in liabilities that pays interest. Although liabilities is not actually bad when it comes to company because that is leverage, no? But the problem is if they are always borrowing, and if let's say the liability, no, our liabilities are more than the equity, then that is already bad for the company. Because in that case, most probably they would then have free cash flow. Kasi baka sa interest pa lang, ubos na yung pera nila, no? Although in the free cash flow, we're not including that in the formula, no? But it, definitely it will be affected. It will be affected, okay? Kasi pagdating doon, no, lagi naman natin tinitingnan is always the free cash flow, no? Not the net worth, but the free cash flow. Okay, so next we have the, you know, DA is the depreciation and amortization. And then we have the CAPEX, no? In CAPEX naman is the capital expenditures. Okay, capital expenditures yan. And then for this one, is the change in the net operating working capital. So for the change in the net operating working capital, you are excluding the short-term interest-bearing liabilities. Now we are excluding the short-term interest-bearing liabilities. So take note, pagdating dyan, laging nagkakamali dyan, no? So we are excluding the short-term interest-bearing liabilities. Okay, so may question ba? Kasi talagang financial management, ang ginagamit natin mga tools dito is accounting. A lot ng mga terms natin na ginagamit dito galing sa accounting, ha? Although may mga terms din tayo na pang-finance talaga, no? But basically, we are using the tools of accounting, especially the financial statements. Kaya dapat mga mahusay tayo sa financial statements talaga, no? You know how to prepare the financial statements and you understood, no? The contents of the financial statements. Kasi otherwise, pagkasulta ko ng salita rito, kahit tanong galing ko mag-explain, siguro halimbawa, you will not understand me. Diba? So, ganun. Kaya try to recall, no, what you learned during your college. Ha? In college days, you know, in accounting and in finance. Okay, so example tayo rito para ma-recall ng konti pa rin, no? So we have the Unlimited Publishing recently reported 10,750 of sales and then 5,500 of operating costs other than depreciation and 1,250 of depreciation. So the company had 3,500 of bonds that carry a 6.25% interest rate and its federal plus state income tax rate was 35%. So during the year, the firm had expenditures on fixed assets and net operating working capital that totaled 1,550. So these expenditures were necessary for it to sustain operations and generate future sales and cash flows. So what was its free cash flow? Ang computation natin, ganito. Diba ito yung formula nga natin? Kaya lang dito, medyo shortcut na, no? Supposedly, ibibigay sa atin dapat rito buong income statement. Kaya lang dito, binigay na yung mga information sa atin na lang, no? So again, the formula is free cash flow is EBIT. Then 1 minus D plus the depreciation and expenses minus the CAPEX plus the change in net operating working capital. So for the EBIT, we have the this one. So, kinuha lang natin itong mga information from the problem. In 10,750 sales, operating expenses, tapos yung the depreciation expense, no? So, we have now the operating income. So, yung operating income natin is also your EBIT. So, kaya meron tayong EBIT ngayon dito, 4,000, tapos 1 minus 0.35. Kasi yung tax rate na binigay sa atin ay 35%. So we have the 35% there. And then plus, now the 1,250, which is the 1,250 here. And depreciation expense there, no? And then minus the 1,550, because it is already given here. Okay? So yan yung binigay sa atin. Okay, now we can compute now. And then you can get 2,300 free cash flow. So meaning the 2,300 can be used to pay for the obligations of the company, okay, additional capital expenditures, or payment for dividends, without a dish or without affecting your operations. Ha? Kasi importante doon, not affecting your operations. Ha? Kaya tinatawag natin na free cash flow. Okay, naintindihan ba yun? Naintindihan ba?
Yes, sir.
Any clarification regarding this? Bakit si ano, wala pa rin? And last time, siya rin yung late. Ngayon, siya pa rin yung late. Ha? Ah, sige. So next, market value added. Okay, so market value added. So one of the limitations of the financial statements is that it does not reflect no, its market value. Why not market value? Because those information, financial information in the income statement or even in the balance sheet, no, are actually historical cost. No? So primarily, we record the transactions at fair market value. But eventually it becomes historical cost because the fair market value that we recorded before will not change even after about 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years. So that's why it becomes historical cost. No? So it does not reflect the market value, the current status, no, or the present amount of those accounts appearing in the financial statements. And then it is a performance indicator showing the difference between the market value of the equity and the total amount of capital supplied by the investors. So based on this, now we can see the progress, no, or the increase, no, in the market value of the company. So in book value niya, kasi basically in nasa financial statements, book value yan. So now we are looking at the market value. So we will see the increase, no, especially on the outstanding shares. So kaya ang formula dyan ay market value of the stock minus the book value of the stock, tapos multiply natin doon sa outstanding shares. So the outstanding shares, these are the shares issued by the company. Shares issued by the company and already paid. Ha? Kasi meron tayong tinatawag na authorized shares, no? But the outstanding shares, these are already issued and paid. Okay? So, example tayo rito. Kaya lang dito, iba yung problem na nailagay ko eh. Ang naibigay ko na kagad yung market value. Na supposedly yung nangahanapin natin, yung market value. Pero dito, ibinigay yung market value. And we are asked to check for the stock price, no? Well, anyway, ito siya. So ABC Corporation has 300 million of common equity with 10 million shares of common stock outstanding. So if ABC's market value added and VA is 162, what is the company's stock price? So meron tayong total book value. No? Yan ay makikita rin sa balance sheet, no? And then we have the number of shares outstanding. And then the market value added is 162,000. So binigay na. So supposedly, ito yung hanapin dapat natin eh. Sa market value. Kaya doon sa problem, binigay ang pinahanap yung price ng stock. So we have the market value now, 162,000. Then we have the total book value of the company. But this one, you have the 10,000 shares. So what is missing is actually the stock. No? So lumalabas, kung 300,000 ito, minus natin yung 162,000, then divided by 10 million. Ay, hindi pala minus, add pala lalabas, no? Kasi negative to. So 300,000 plus 162,000, so that is, mali na naman ako, hindi pala 1,000 yan, million, no? 300 million, then 162 million, add, you will get 462 million. And then divide by that 10,000 shares, so makukuha natin ay 46.20. So lumalabas pala, kung 46.20 yung price ngayon niya, no? Ibig sabihin lang nun, ang book value per share niya dati ay 30 pesos. Now, 30 pesos yung book value per share niya. Paano nakuha yun? 300,000 divided by 10 million shares. So that is 30. So ang difference, bali lumalabas, yung 16.20. No? So the book value of the company, which is 30 pesos, actually increased to 46.20 as the market value. Ah, ganun siya lumalabas. So now we know that the company progressed, di ba? Kasi from the book value of 30, now the market value is 46.20, no? Which is more than the book value per share of the company. So maganda yung performance ng company kasi yung market value na mataas na doon sa book value na. Now, pangit, halimbawa yung book value pa ang mas mataas kaysa sa market value. Because meaning, it is not a good source of investment. Ha? Okay, so next, yung economic at palagay ko, ito yung last. Patama ito na yung last. And then, we will have an exercise, no? Parang konting application lang before we go to the reporting. Sino ba magre-report, by the way, na mauuna? Working capital management. Ah, ikaw, Reda. Sige, mabuti naman, no? So, now we have the economic value added. So, it is a measure of the company's performance based on the difference between the net operating profit and the total invested capital multiplied by the after-tax weighted average cost of capital. So, yun, problema na naman natin dito, ano yung weighted average cost of capital, no? So, yung weighted average cost of capital, explain natin ng konti, ha? So, let's say you have a, you'd like to finance a project, no? So, let's say yung project nyo ay worth 50M. 50M yung worth ng project. So, as yung sabi nyan, how much of the 50 million project would be financed by debt? Okay, liability lang. And equity. Okay, so how much is to be financed by liabilities and equity? So parang katulad sa kotse, halimbawa, no? Pagka bumili ka ng kotse, di ba, may tinatawag tayo na equity na 20% palagi. So pagka ganun dito, halimbawa sinabi natin 20% equity, meaning this one is 80. So which is equivalent to what? So lalabas ito ay equivalent to 40M. Then this one is equivalent to 10M. Ha? Ganun lalabas yun. So yung 50 million project, it will be financed by 80% liabilities, which is equivalent to 40 million, and then 10 million M. Now, once you borrowed money, no, may cost yan. So let's say the cost is 8% for the interest. Okay? This one for the equity, meron din siyempre cost yan. So let's say 10% in the form of dividends naman. Okay, so ganyan. So to compute for the WACC now, lalabas equivalent to, let's say this one, the 8% is already the net of tax. No? Let's say, okay, lagay na lang natin para mas maliwanag. No? Let's say the tax rate is 30%. So to compute for the WACC now, we have the 0.08 then times 1 minus 0.0 0.30, and then multiplied by 80%, 0.80. Then plus, we have the 0.10 times the 0.20. So yan yung kanilang weight lumalabas, no? So ganyan yung pag-compute, bale. So that is your weighted average cost of capital. So compute natin para makita niyo yung result. So we have 0.08 times 0.70 times 0.80. So this is 0.0448 and plus.
Akala ko ako yung naglag siya.
Ako din. Akala ko ako. Hi, sir.
Nawala ako. Ako yata yung nawala.
Yes, no? Yes po, sir.
Oo nga, ako yung nawala. Sorry, saan ba ako nawala?
Saan sir, yung kinakapit ko, yung double.
Okay, buti na lang nakita ko. Akala ko pumasok si yung isa, kaya bigla akong na, ano, nawala pala ako. So anyway, ito na siya, no? So we have the 0.08 times 1 minus 0.30 times 0.80. Tapos yun yung makukuha natin, 0.0448. Then you have that 0.10 times 0.20. So you have 0.02, no? So ibig sabihin nun, ito yung ating ano, 0.0648 or 6.48. So yan yung ating weighted average cost of capital. So if that is the weighted average cost of capital, ibig sabihin nun, this project, no, the retrain should be at least 6.48%. Okay? So the project, the 50 million, the retrain on that, when you see retrain, is of course the income, no? That should be 6.48%. Ha? Kasi lugi tayo pagka bumaba dito. Okay? So dapat at least 6.48%. Maliwanag ba yun? So, pagdating dito ngayon, ito na yun, no? Ito yung explain ko kanina, WACC. Okay, so, may question ba muna pala o clarification regarding this?
Okay.
Di ba classmate mo, Eunice, yung isa?
Ay, hindi po, sir.
Di ba classmate yun? Nako.
Si Red po yung classmate ko.
Ah, si Red yung classmate mo? Yung isa, ayun yung medyo may ano na, no? Yung matagal nang graduate, hindi from Miriam College, no? Ah, nako.
Opo.
Kala ko si ano. Okay, anyway. So, yun ang problema nito, baka mahirapan siya, baka hindi na nakikita yung competition nito. Kaya gusto ko naghihintay pagka ganito eh. So anyway, wala
sir, naman. Recording naman.
Okay. So bagay yung recording, no? Pero syempre, kailangan ko rin ng participation at saka yung presence, di ba? Parang, anyway, so bagay, may recording naman tayo ngayon. At saka meron pala ako in-upload yata last time, di ba? Na-upload ko sa inyo, ha?
Yes, please, sir. Yes.
So ayan, bali ito yung importance nito WCC, no? So that the retrain, no, at least 6.48%, because otherwise you will not accept that. You will not accept the project, ha? So punta tayo rito ngayon. Ayan, balik tayo ulit. So this economic value added, it reflects how efficient and profitable the company in terms of the investment made is, no? So EVA shows not just the accounting profit, but the firm's economic profit by deducting the required retrain from the net operating profit of the company. So this is actually the difference between the economists and the accountants. Kasi the way we compute for the profit, yung katulad nito nga. No, this is how we compute for the profit. Itong buong ito. Yan. No? Pero sa accountant, hindi. Ah, sa economist, hindi. Nandito siya. No, nag-multiply siya ng 1 minus T. No, tapos, binawas niya yung WCC. That's multiplied by the supplied capital. So, yan ang formula ng economist. Not to get the economic the profit. And they called it economic profit. Pero accountant naman kasi, wala itong part na to. Diba? Pero dire-diretso siya hanggang doon sa ilalim. No? Wala itong part na to. Ha? Kaya kung makikita nyo rito sa PowerPoint natin, ito yung formula niya. Ha? Supplied capital, yung total invested capital times the WACC. At sinasabi niya, dapat yung EBIT, no, less the tax, should be more than the total invested capital times WACC for you to have a positive economic value added, or there is an economic value added to the company. As you get red question.
Sir, if ganun, like what you mentioned just now, if ganun po yung, if ito lang yung ginagamit ng economist, isn't that less accurate compared to what the accountants are using?
Hindi naman siya less accurate, but of course it depends on the perception, no, of the one using it. Kasi yung accounting, alam mo, sa for the accountants, for example, ang kinukonsider pa namin mga approvals, for example, di ba? Pero it does not mean na meron less accurate between the two. No, but that is the way they analyze the performance of the company. Let's say for the economist niya, they are more on the WACC, the one who finance, no? And what is the cost of financing that you have? And then they are referring to, for you to have an economic value added, the economist profit, ganyan ito dapat ang pag-compute ang sinasabi nila. Kaya nga may contest eh. Nagko-contest ang accountant chain at saka yung economist. Because they have different perceptions when it comes to computing the profit. Ganyan siya. No? But I cannot see now one is less efficient, the other one is more efficient. I cannot tell that. No? It depends on how you perceive or the perception regarding the performance of the company. But of course, the basic still is this one. Ito pa rin yung pinaka-basic. Ha? Yan pa rin yung pinaka-basic. But some formulas are developed for the purpose of analysis. Okay ba yan?
Thank you po. Yes, clear po.
Okay, so problem tayo ngayon, ha? So, Kronos Incorporated recently reported the following information. So, we have the net income. No? Yung net income. Actually, itong net income natin, ito yung EBIT, no? Okay. So, actually, ito yung... Ay, hindi, tama. Yung net income is the net income. Kaya meron pa tayong computation ng EBIT rito. So, we have the tax rate of 40%. Interest expense of 200,000, And then the total invested operating capital employed is 9 million, and the after-tax cost of capital is 10%. So what is the company's EVA? So since ang binigay rito sa atin yung net income, so kung kukunin natin sa income statement dyan, ang binigay sa atin ito. No? Ang kailangan natin, ito. Ha? Ito ang binigay, but we need this amount. So what we can do is, yun na nga, net income, divide natin ng 1 minus T. No? Bawas natin yung tax rate from 1. So, makukuha natin 0.60. So, ibig sabihin, 1 million pala yung ano, yung bagay, ito, sulat natin para mas maliwanag sa inyo, ha? Nasaan ba yung ginawa natin? Net income daw nandito. 600,000. So, kung ang tax pala ay 40%, ibig sabihin nun, ito ay 60%. For you to get the 100%, itong 600,000, divide natin sa 60%. No? So, kaya makukuha natin dito ngayon ay 1 million. Okay? And meron tayong interest expense na 200. No? So, ganyan. So, dito dati ay less. So, syempre, for you to get the EBT, EBIT, so this must be 1,200,000. So, kaya pagdating dito, 1,200,000 tayo ngayon. No? Okay, so we have the EVA is equivalent to EBIT minus 1 minus T. So, ibig sabihin nun, yung 720,000 is already net of tax. So, 1,200,000 times 60%, so this one is 720,000. Then WECC, we have the WECC natin dito. Ito, after tax cost of capital, 10%. E meron tayong total invested capital na 9 million. Diba? 9 million siya. So 9 million times that 10%. So, ito yung cost of capital, yan din yung WCC natin. Ha? So, 10%, kaya ito yung nakuha natin, 900,000. So, 720,000 minus 900,000, meron tayong economic value added na negative 180,000. So, for the economist, hindi siya kumita. Ganun lumalabas. But of course, for the accountant, no? Kumita sila ng 600,000. But if you use the economic value added, no? For the economist, hindi kumita yung company because the economic value added is negative 180,000. Okay? Oh, so, ganun siya. Okay, diretso tayo, ha? Okay, punta tayo ngayon dito. So, meron tayo dito, exercise tayo ngayon, na exercise. Oh, if a typical firm, no, reports 20 billion of retained earnings on its balance sheet, could its directors declare a 20 million cash dividend without any, having any qualms about what they were doing? And then explain your answer. So, kung natatanda niyo pa yung financial management niyo noon, pwede ba siya mag-declare ng dividends dito? Yun ang tanong. Ha? Pwede ba? Tingnan niyo. Okay, so tignan natin. Idea mo, Eunice.
So I think it's too much money not to declare any claim about it.
Oo.
That they should be able to explain it po. Why sila magde-declare ng ganong kalaking dividend.
Ano, pakiulit, tag ano ka, nag-chop, nag-chop you. Ulit, ulit.
Sir, I think po na yung directors po na when they declare the 20 million cash dividend, they should have a claims about it po. Yes po. Kasi
have funds.
Po, kasi masyadong malaki yung pera na
okay.
to have.
Sige, si Red naman kaya. Si Red.
I agree po with Ate Eunice and also the retained earnings po kasi it's the same amount with the cash dividend.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not sure if I'm getting something from there. Pero I think it's quite impossible.
Mm-hmm. But the answer is yes, no? It can be possible. It is possible to declare dividends. Huh? Kasi when it comes to the restriction only, no restriction. A restriction when it comes to declaring of dividends is that the company should only have positive retained earnings. Or if the retained earnings is unappropriated, it cannot be included. So in short, the retained earnings should be unappropriated. And if the retained earnings unappropriated is enough to pay for the dividends, then it is possible, no? Walang problema. So in that case, actually, pwede siya mag-declare ng dividends. Actually, kahit nga limbawa, 10 pesos lang yun. Yung cash na limbawa, no? Kahit 10 pesos lang yung cash niya. Pero ang retained earnings mo, 20 million unappropriated, magde-declare siya ng 20 million cash dividend, pwede pa rin. Ha? Kahit na 10 pesos lang yung cash niya sa banko, pwede silang mag-declare ng dividends. Because the restriction is more on the unappropriated retained earnings. If the amount of cash is available, I mean if the amount of retained earnings unappropriated can cover, no, the dividends to be declared by the directors, then it is possible. There's no problem in declaring dividends. Huh? Okay, so number two, ito. If you were an investor, why might you be more interested in free cash flow than net income? So bakit? Bakit mas interested kayo dyan than the net income? Okay, explain ko na kanina, di ba? Ha? Explain ko na kanina. Bakit mas interested sila sa free cash flow kesa sa net income? Bakit kaya? Can you guess why they are more interested in free cash flow? Anyone? Wala? Sige. Kasi ang reason dyan is because this one is already free cash flow. No? Diba? Explanation kanina regarding free cash flow is that the free cash flow can already be used for payment of dividends, payment of obligations, or buying additional capital, no? Or capital expenditures. Diba? Yun yung sinabi ko kanina. Without affecting the operations of the company. Diba? Yun ang sinabi ko kanina. Bakit net income? Because under the net income, when we prepare, when the accountants prepare the income statement of the company, we are using the accrual basis. Now we are not using the cash basis of accounting. But we are using the accrual basis of accounting. And when we say accrual basis of accounting, we are recording income even if we did not receive cash payment yet. And then we are recording expenses even if they are not paid yet, but already incurred. No? So the reason why this one is more appropriate or more interested, no, the investors, because that is the amount that can be used for additional investment, payment of dividends, or payment of obligations without affecting the operations of the company. Okay? Yun lang yung sagot dyan sa number 2. So, meron actually ditong problem pa, no? Problem. So, ito. Sagutan din natin kaya, no? Bago tayo punta sa reporting, ha? Sino susunod sa'yo, Red? Si Eunice? Eunice, susunod ka ba dito?
Apo.
Kahit pala wala yung isa, pwede, no? Kaya lang nga, ano siya, o na-miss na yung discussion. Sige, next. So meron tayo si Merichia Holdings Limited, financial statements, pesos and shares are in millions, are provided here, no? So ito yung mga binigay sa atin. Okay? Then we also have the income statement. So tinatanong ngayon, what was the net working capital for 2019 and 2020? So magko-compute tayo ngayon. So yung net working capital is total current assets, tapos plus minus the sum of the accounts payable and accruals. So this is for 2019. So for 2019, ang kukunin lang natin, ito bale, at saka ito 9,000 and 6,000. So yan, no? So the reason why it is 59 minus 9 plus 6, 44,000. Ha? Then for 2020, ganun din. Itong kukunin natin. Then we have this one. And then another one. So lalabas 72,125 minus the 10,8 and 76. So makukuha natin ngayon ay 53,725. Okay? So now, what was Merichia's holdings, no, for 2023 cash flow? So kukunin natin ngayon dito ngayon ay EBIT, itong 39,000. Ano ba? 39,000. So kaya pagdating rito, meron tayong 39,000, then times 1 minus 0.4 plus dagdag natin yung depreciation, ayan, 5,000. Okay, so ito yung mga kinuha natin values, ha? Ayan. Okay? So ayan yung depreciation. So we add ito na yun, ito. And then we deduct the capital expenditures. Yung capital expenditures natin, saan ba kinuha yung capital expenditures dito? Dapat dito lang siya. May binigay bang capital expenditures? Wala. So dito lang siya, no? 47 minus ano? May sinabi bang capital expenditures dito? Baka given na lang siya. So anyway, yung capital expenditures, pinakita niya na 8,000. So kaya ito yung 8,000, no? But the 9,725, we obtained here by getting the difference between the two. Ito yung difference, 53,725 and 44,000. Okay, so kaya pagdating rito, 9,725. Tapos dito, kaya naging 8,000 yan, kasi yung difference na 3,000, ito yung 3,000, tignan nyo. Ito. Yung difference na 3,000. O 3,000 pesos. Kasi nagkaroon siya ng accumulated depreciation. So lumalabas dito, 47,000. Baligyan itong computation na, tandaan nyo ito ha, depreciation na. So lumalabas yung parang ganito siya. 50,000. Tapos meron tayong 47,000. Tapos minus 5,000 dito. So, lumalabas yan ay 42. Ang difference ay 8,000. So, yung 47,000 na ito kasi, nabawasan ng depreciation expense. Ito yun. No, ito yung 47,000, nabawasan muna ng 5,000 na depreciation expense. Ha? So, kasi mayroong depreciation expense dito eh. Diba? Kaya 47,000 minus 5,000. So, makukuha natin ngayon ay 42,000. So, 42,000 minus 50,000 dito, bawas natin sa 50,000, you have 8,000. So, kaya meron tayo dito 8,000. So, the free cash flow now is 10,675. Okay? So, that's the end of financial statement analysis.